Hello everybody, here Rene from Spain with a new video. I'm outside and I hope so the camera is not falling down. It's on top of a bottle, but it's quite a lot of wind right now. Okay, in this video I'm going to show vinyl that I've been playing in the shop, you know, the last 2-3 weeks. And let's start with this one. This was the only full length album by this band. And this was recorded live. Surface, Raise the Night. If you like bands like Top Rock, Heavy Petting, for example, Shy, you know, bands from the UK playing melodic hard rock, new wave of British heavy metal, but the melodic, very melodic sides, even some Praying Mantis mixed with Magnum a little bit, the touch, I think you will like this album. It's not a perfect recording. The sound is quite weak, but it's an okay album. It's got some cool songs on it. I play this one, We Are Motorhead, by Motorhead from 2000. This is an original pressing actually that I bought when this was released, but now it's re-released, you know, on vinyl. I listened to this one that I bought not long ago. Finally, I bought this on vinyl. 180 Gram, the second album by Poison. Sounds amazing, sounds a lot better than the CD or the tape I have. I also listened to some Scorpions. This is an EP, a live EP from 1979. Great stuff, great sound. I listened to Nitro. This is Lethal Plus 2. This kind of was a re-release on Mausoleum. Original, I think it was an EP, and now it became a full-length album because they put two extra songs to it. I think something like that happened. You see? This is not a Nitro with Jimmy Galette or something, I don't remember his name exactly, but the guy later got married to Lita Ford. Headhunter, these are the band from Switzerland. One of the guys in this band later became the guitar player of Krokus, Manny Maurer, this guy. This is not the Schmier Headhunter, this is pure heavy metal from 85. And I listened to some more Scorpions. I listened to Taken by Force and Virgin Killer. Two great records, of course. This is a Spanish edition. Gatefold. See? Two albums in one. And this came out in 1982. Of course, the albums are from the 70s. And so many great songs. Steam Rock Fever, We'll Burn the Sky. The Cells of Sharon, amazing song. He's a Woman, She's a Man. Born to Touch Your Feelings. And from Virgin Killer, I really like Picture Life. Catch a Train. Virgin Killer, of course. Crying Days. Just great albums, you know. And I think you could hear a little bit of the metal, you know, the heavier side already. On Virgin Killer especially, you know, some of the guitars sounded really like they did a show in the early 80s, or, you know, really cool. Of course, some of the songs sounds a lot like Jimi Hendrix, you know, the way Uli Roth was playing the guitar. But some riffs already reminds me of Lover Drive from 79 or Blackout, you know, stuff like that. Some touches. Molly Hatchet, Crow Molly. I always confuse the names. Molly Hatchet is a totally different band. This is a band from the UK. Not bad at all. Somebody else showed it on the VC the other day. And I played it because he showed it. I also played these two albums because I made a video, you know, showing this stuff by Accept and Udo from the 90s. I had to listen to it again. Cold Sweat. This is a band that Mark Ferrari started it after when Keel got disbanded. Some stuff I already showed, but I'm not going to show it again. I listened to these two Wrath albums. Maybe I'm saying it wrong, but power metal from the USA from the mid 80s. Cool stuff. I listened to Litterfort. This is a really good album. You see, it's like you got a lot of good songs on here. Because you all know this album. I already made a review about this album. You know, my channel. You can watch a whole video about this album. Listen to the two albums by Lee Mans. See? This one was more heavy metal, this one. And this one became more melodic. You also can see the way the guys looked, of course, when they looked in the early 80s or in the mid to late 80s. You see, things changed. And this is actually a promo copy. I never realized that. I bought these records during the 90s. Axis from Germany, from 2001 album. This is actually limited to 500 copies. I bought this also when it was released. Could be a rare one now, but back then it was easy to get because people were not buying vinyl in 2001, practically. Hawk, great guitar player this band had, and just a great album. Hawk. Matt Sorum from LA Guns, from The Cult and Guns N' Roses fame. He was playing the drums on this album. This is from 1986. I also played Armed Forces with Michael Henry. He died maybe around 10 years ago. Or I don't know exactly when he died. And he was also in the band August Red Moon. And he was in the band Eden. Great sing vocalist. Kraft, AOR from Germany. They made a couple of records. Here we have Mass, the Swiss Connection. They were living at the border from Germany. I think some of the members were from Switzerland and some were from Germany, if I'm not mistaken. And this band is actually back. You know, they returned not long ago and they have a new album out with some re-recorded songs and some new tracks too. Don't confuse them with Mass from America. Talking about America, this band is from there. Only two guys of Japan were playing also on this album. And this is an EP actually, 6-song EP. Heavy metal, really cool songs. And I listened to Black Sabbath. Sabbath Bloody Sabbath. This is probably my favorite Black Sabbath album with Ozzy Osbourne. This is the first one I got, you know, in the late 80s, early 90s. I bought this one, 1974 originally. I listened to this band from Mexico, Luz Bell. This is from 87. It's not as good as Pasaporte al Infierno. I like this album a lot more, but it has a couple of good songs on it, but not my favorite, Luz Bell. And here we have the last one I'm going to show. This is an AOR Canadian band. And I think they were, one of them was actually in the band Touch. And Touch played at the first Monsters of Rock festival in Donington. You know, together with Rainbow, Scorpions, Riot, and also Touch played there. I think they opened that day in Monsters of Rock Donington 1980, and later in the late 80s he formed the band Drive C-Set. And Drive C-Set, they released an album a couple years ago called Pedal to the Metal, and Pedal to the Metal is a great album too, but this is maybe their most famous record, Drive C-Set on Music for a Nation. Okay everybody, I hope so you like this video. And stay metal.